Recently, a couple of big YouTube channels reached out to me, said they admire my work and asked me to do a video on the battery bounce test. The way this works is, if you drop a new battery on its end, it doesn't bounce and sometimes even stands up. But if the battery is used or depleted and you drop it, it bounces sometimes the full length of a battery or more. It's pretty amazing. That's what we're gonna do. Let's get into it. These are the batteries that I'm going to bounce. I have three of the Kirkland brand and three Duracells. I'm gonna get all my dischargers set up, discharge these batteries, and bounce three different voltages. New, half discharged, and fully discharged. I'm gonna start discharging the batteries. I'm gonna discharge it at about 300 milliamps. For the lowest discharged battery, I'm gonna go down to 1.2 volts, which is usually fully discharged for alkaline. My batteries are all discharged. I have them all mixed up, so this is a perfect opportunity for me to try the bounce test and see if I can tell the difference between the ones that are new and the ones that are discharged. Here's the first one. Oh, that one didn't bounce at all. That one seemed to bounce kind of a little. Oh, that one bounced for sure. So my guess is that this is gonna be the discharge battery. This one is gonna be the medium battery, and this is gonna be the full battery. This one bounces the most. This one's kind of in between, and this one doesn't bounce at all. First thing I wanna do before setting everything up is measure the voltage of each battery and write it on the side. So when we look at the high speed footage, we can see which battery is which. All of the voltages are marked on my batteries, and this is gonna give us a good indication to how much bounce is associated with how much discharge. The biggest issue everybody else had with this test was getting the batteries to drop all at the same time. So I put together a rig, I'm calling it the drop rig, and this is gonna drop all of the batteries within 1 millisecond of one another to give us fair results. All I need to do now is put all of these batteries in order, hit the switch, and drop them. All right, we're all set. This is gonna be drop number one in 3, 2, 1. Okay, let's take a look at that high speed footage and see which one of these batteries dropped first. All right, that looked a lot more amazing than I thought it was gonna look. And if you're wondering why dead batteries bounce, there's actually a reason for it. Because the electrolyte in new batteries is a gel-like substance, and it kind of acts like sand or buckshot in a dead blow hammer. When the battery drops, that gel-like electrolyte absorbs the shock of the drop and the battery stops in its place. When the electrolyte is depleted, the more depleted it gets, the more dense that electrolyte becomes, and the less shock it absorbs. So basically, when a dead battery falls, there is no gel-like substance to absorb that shock, so the battery bounces. That's why dead batteries bounce, just in case you were wondering. Okay, so this is gonna be my second drop on the steel plate, and this time I'm going to line them up in order of voltage from lowest to highest, ready to go. See how it looks. This time what I did different is I discharged this battery a little bit more, these 1.4 batteries. I discharged them another 500 milliamp hours. So here we go. 3, 2, 1. That looked pretty amazing. Oh my, no, I'm just kidding. Now I look pretty smooth though. Our 1.2 volt Duracell battery was the one that won the pole vault competition because this battery jumped over all the other ones and stood in the air, got some serious air time. You can see that all of the batteries were released at precisely the same moment. So my rig worked great. But the Duracell batteries seem to be slightly heavier than the Kirkland batteries because they all hit the platform at just a slight fraction of a second earlier, fraction of a millisecond probably. So that was it for this. I'm gonna remove this steel plate now and do one more drop on the straight countertop. And then, take a look and see how it looks on the countertop and then wrap this thing up. This is gonna be my last and final setup here. And this is the straight counter. That's it. So that's my take on bouncing batteries. I learned a lot in this episode, and I also learned a new way to check batteries to see if they're dead or not. I mean, anybody could do that, right? Kids would love to do that. You know how many times I've given my nieces and nephews new batteries for their toys and they mix them up and I walk over there and I'm like, oh, now I gotta get a tester and test the batteries. I never knew about this battery bouncing thing, believe it or not. So that was my take on a battery bouncing. Check out the other episodes and don't forget to subscribe. This wouldn't be YouTube without asking you to subscribe. Adios.